Hello, what's up? In this tutorial, I want to show you how you can change a pretty boring and flat landscape photo to a much more interesting one by adding lights and shadows. Most of this will be done using the Camera Raw Editor. That means this can also be done in Adobe Lightroom Classic. So let's start. This is our raw image. To get this nice motion blur in the clouds, I did use an exposure time of around 2 minutes. And while the clouds are pretty interesting right away, the foreground is really boring since it's just all in the same color tone and it's pretty flat and it's just lacking some contrast overall. By making use of those natural occurring shapes of those hills, we can actually add some lights and some shadows, making use of some local adjustments. But first, let's start by changing the profile to Adobe Standard. Then in the basic panel right away, I'm not touching the white balance since right now it looks pretty accurate. Let's just boost the contrast a little bit, introduce some whites to make this image brighter. Just keep an eye on the histogram to not overexpose anything. I think that looks okay for now. Also, I want to introduce some more sharpness by increasing the texture. And let's boost the vibrance for some more saturation. And that's pretty much all there is for the basic adjustments. You can see the foreground still lacks a lot of contrast. We don't have any lights and don't have any shadows in here. As I said, this will come using local adjustments. First, let me start with a gradiated filter. This one is just for the sky actually. I want to use it to bring out some more structure from those clouds. So I'm starting by dropping the exposure very, very slightly. And I'm also bringing up the highlights. Let's also introduce some whites. Bring down the blacks to add some contrast. And maybe even add some clarity. Okay, that looks pretty nice. Now we're done with the upper part of the image. Now let's paint in some light. What I want to do to this image is to make that hill in the background brighter and thus make it appear to be hit by the sunlight. And also at the same time, I want to make the hill in the foreground darker, so it kind of lies in the shadow of a cloud or something. In this case, that's pretty easy since you can see the shape of the hill in the background is similar to a radial filter. So first off, let's try to recreate this shape with a simple radial filter. Something like this looks pretty good. Now you can see the radial filter is overlapping the hill on the left side, and that's not a big deal. We can just erase it later. For now, since I have feather activated, this radial filter will be weaker on the outer border of it. So I'm just dropping the feather and give it this hard edge. And we can always make it softer by erasing parts of it. Just keep that in mind. So with this radial filter, let's introduce some light, and that's pretty easy. Just bring up the exposure first. Just a little bit helps quite a bit already. We can also increase the whites to further increase the brightness in there. And let's add some highlights. And we can even adjust the color temperature to make it look like the sun is directly hitting this mountain. So let's just increase the temperature and make this area a little warmer. All right, nice. Right now you can clearly see the edge of this radial filter, but as I said, we can simply erase that by selecting it. And here you can find the eraser tool. Then just carefully brush along this radial filter to fix all those areas. And you can see this works really, really good. Now you can already spot a huge difference between the original raw image and the edited one. But let's continue with the shadows in the foreground. Again, let's just create the radial filter, since again, this shape fits the radial filter pretty good. We might need to zoom out a little bit. Therefore, I am holding down the Alt key and just use the mouse wheel to zoom out. That looks pretty good. Let's give it a try. And of course, to create the shadow, I'm simply decreasing the exposure. So in this case, you might want to use a little bit of feather. That does look pretty good. We actually don't need to erase anything from this radial filter. So let's continue. Of course, we not only can use the radial filters, but the brush tool as well, which you can find right there. So let's say we want to introduce some more brightness to this hill. Let's just paint on top of this right here. And let's bring up the exposure. Let's also increase the highlights and maybe the whites. Okay, that looks pretty sweet. I think I want to continue with the brush on this side. Again, there is some overlapping in the dark area right there. So let's just use the eraser here and go over it manually. All right, nice. We still have a little bit of a shadow right there, but I actually think it looks a bit more natural than to just have this bright hill on the right side. So I want to keep that. Now let's also use the brush tool to make the left side a little darker. Here I don't need to be that precise. I can just paint over the left side like that. Now let's bring down the exposure. Okay, that looks pretty nice. Let's compare to the original image. So here you can see a huge difference between this flat, boring landscape and this contrast-rich, a little more engaging landscape image. Again, as you just saw, this was all created by using simple local adjustments in the Camera Raw editor, which of course also can be found in Adobe Lightroom Classic. So you can do that there as well. And that's it for the part about creating light and shadows. So I hope this tutorial was helpful. At this point, I still want to finish the editing, so feel free to stay. Since we're done with the local adjustments, I want to further continue doing the color grading, and I'm starting in the color mixer. Here I want to adjust the hue tones a bit, and I think this hill on the right side might be a little too yellow. I want to make it look a little more fresh, and therefore let's just boost the yellow hue more into the green range. Just like that. Then in the saturation tab, I also want to boost the yellow saturation, which will affect those green tones as well. Maybe I'm bringing down the blue tone slightly. Okay, then let's also check the luminance tab. Maybe we can boost the yellow luminance a bit. Okay, and let's drop the blue luminance for a darker sky. That's pretty much it for the color grading. I'm not touching the split toning right there, since I think the colors do look pretty nice. However, I want to sharpen the image in the details tab. So let's do this real quick. Alright, and now we can finish it in Photoshop. So first, of course, I want to clean up the image from sensor spots, so let me duplicate that layer by hitting Ctrl J. Then I'm grabbing the spot healing brush and just zoom in a bit so I can be a little more precise. Okay, sensor spot wise, this looks pretty good. I still want to clean up a few more things. First, let me get rid of this line going over the whole hill there. Again, I'm just going over it using the spot healing brush. Photoshop shouldn't have any problems fixing the texture here. Okay, nice. Then let's clean up the bright spots in the very near foreground, since they are distracting. And of course, I want to get rid of this forest right there. This is a little trickier, so I'm again duplicating this layer, just in case I mess something up, so I do have a backup layer. Here I'm using the clone stem tool. I can copy an area by holding down the Alt key, let's say right here, and now I can simply hover over the spot I want to remove right there. This way I can paint in the copied area from up there. Okay, nice. And then I want to check the Nick collection for some final effects. what I think would look pretty good here is the polarization effect. So let's just turn up the strength here. Yeah, I think the field in the foreground looks really beautiful. Let's apply it like this. Okay. And at this point, I'm pretty much done with editing this image. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.